Good morning students. Today we are studied about the third chapter of standard 11 chemistry, that is basic analytical techniques. In this chapter today we are studied about the first part, that is introduction and purification of solids. In this chapter we are studied about the introduction of the basic analytical techniques, then purification of solids. In purification of solids, we are mainly studied about the two techniques, in which the first is the filtration technique and another is the crystallization. The filtration technique, it is of two types, that is simple filtration and filtration under suction. And in crystallization, we are studied about the fractional crystallization. Then the second is the distillation. Distillation, it is of three types. The first is the simple distillation, second one is the fractional distillation, and third one is the distillation under reduced pressure. Next is the solvent extraction method, and last one is the chromatographic techniques. In chromatographic techniques, we have studied about the two types. One is adsorption chromatography and second one is the partition chromatography. In adsorption chromatography, it is again of two types, that is column chromatography and thin layer chromatography. Now today we have studied about the only introduction and purification of solids. So now let's start the topic. Before studying the analytical techniques, first of all we see what is meant by the analytical chemistry. The analytical chemistry is defined as, it is the branch of chemistry which deals with the study of separation, that means we want the separate substance from mixture of the various types of the substances, then identification, qualitative and quantitative determination of the composition of the different substance is the analytical chemistry. Now it is found that there has been a schematic development, and the techniques which are used for the analysis of chemical substance, we are use the various types of techniques for the determination of chemical substances. But in this chapter we are studying the mainly basic analytical techniques, that are purification and the separation techniques. Now see, what is the need for the purification of the substances? As we know, the chemical substance which are occur in nature are in the impure stage, that means any substance found in the nature, or it is either prepared the artificially in the laboratory, it is also found in the impure form. Then we want the substance in the nature by pure form, or prepared the substance in the pure form. So the chemical substance occur in the nature, it is impure form, or when it is synthesized in the laboratory, they are obtained in the crude form or the impure form. For example, the salt, that is NaCl, which are found in the sea, it is present the various types of impurity. And the metal, it contains also the ores or the various types of substances which are synthesized in the laboratory, it also contains the various types of impurity. So if we want to study the various types of chemicals, then we want that substance in their pure form. Without substance obtaining in their pure form, we cannot study their properties or analysis is to be done. So before investigating their composition and the properties, it is essential to obtain them in the pure form. Then method of purification and separation of the compounds, it is depend on the difference in their physical properties. Physical properties like their melting point, their boiling point, density, all these are depends. For example, if any substance is present and there is presence of various types of impurity, then their melting point or boiling point has to be varied. So we want the substance in their purified form. So now studied about the various purification of the solids. Any substance found in the nature, it is of the three types, that is either solid, liquid or gases. A solid substance may contain the two types of impurity. The first one, which are soluble in the same solvent as the main substance. For example, if we take the example of salt and sugar, both salt and sugar are dissolved in the same solvent, that is the water. That means when we take the sugar and salt in water, both substances are soluble in the same solvent, that is water. So it is the first type. And second is the which are not soluble in the same solvent as the substance. The example is when we take the mixture of sand and the salt. In this case, the sand and salt are taken in the water, but in water only salt is dissolved or soluble and the sand is not dissolved, not soluble. So it is the example of second type. But we have studied only the second types of, that is which are not soluble in the same solvent as the substance, and we are not studied about the now first type of impurity. So the second type of impurity, that means which are not soluble in the same solvent as the substance, means only one substance is soluble in the solvent. It can be separated easily using a soluble suitable solvent to dissolve the main compound. Means main compound has to be dissolved in the suitable solvent. And when the impurities remain undissolved, it can be separated by the simple process known as the filtration. It is the definition of filtration. Now the simple example of filtration which we have be done in our house is making the tea. In tea making, we have used the milk, then sugar and tea leaves. In milk, as the sugar is completely dissolved, but tea leaves are not dissolved. And when we have to filter the tea, then the non-dissolved tea leaves, it is found into the upper part, that is in filter. And in when we have to filter the tea, we get the sugar which is dissolved in the milk. Now the purification of solid, in which we have studied the filtration process, it is of two types. That is, first one is the simple filtration and second one is the filtration under suction. So first we study about the simple filtration techniques. For the formation of separation of mixture of water and sand by simple filtration, first of all we take the mixture of water and sand in one beaker, and then we have to take the one funnel. This is the funnel in which we have to place the filter paper. The filter paper has to be placed in the circular, and then it can be made in the cone which is placed in the funnel. Then this circular piece of filter paper, it is folded to form the cone and it is fitted on this funnel. The funnel, this is the funnel, has to be placed on the stand, and the beaker is kept below it. The paper is made moist. The solution is to be filtered is poured on the filter paper. The filter paper is moist, as we know that paper has to be absorbed some amount of water, and we don't want to unutilize any types of the mixture. So first of all, we have to make the filter paper moist by using water or any solution. Then the insoluble part which are remaining on the filter paper, it is the residue. In this case, as sand is not dissolved in the water, that means in residue we get the sand, and the liquid collected in the beaker, it is the filtrate. Means this is the water which is we get the filtrate after filtration. This is the simple filtration techniques. Now the second one is the filtration under suction. When the filtration is carried out using the vacuum pump, then it is known as the filtration under suction. In our house, there is presence of the vacuum cleaner. In vacuum cleaner, it can be sucked all the types of dirt present in that place. Similar, in the filtration under suction, we use the suction pump. This technique, it is more faster, more efficient technique than the simple filtration. This is the simple filtration technique, but as compared to simple filtration technique, this filtration under suction, it is more faster, more efficient, more accurate techniques. This is the assembly for the filtration under suction. And in the filtration under suction, it consists of the thick wall conical flask. This is the thick wall conical flask, which is known as the Bucknell flask. This Bucknell flask, it is connected with this sidearm. This is the sidearm, and in this sidearm there is presence of rubber tube, and rubber tube is attached to the safety bottle. Here we have to place the safety bottle. Now, what is the use of placing the safety ball to the sidearm by using rubber tube? Now, sometimes it is found that the filtrate when comes into the Bucknell flask, it is going to flask, sometimes it is goes to this sidearm, and as there is presence of the suction pump, it can be creates a problem in the suction pump. So to prevent this, we have to place the safety bottle at this place. So it consists of the thick wall. This is the thick wall conical flask with this sidearm. The flask is connected to the safety bottle. Here we have to place the safety bottle by using the rubber tube. This is the rubber tube to this sidearm. This is the sidearm. The safety bottle is used to prevent the sucking the filtrate into the suction pump. Then at upper part, the special porcelain funnel called as an Bucknell funnel. This is the Bucknell funnel. It is fitted in the conical flask with the help of the rubber cork. This is the rubber cork, and by using rubber cork, we have to fit this Bucknell funnel into the Bucknell flask. Now, in the Bucknell funnel, it consists of the various types of the porous circular bottom. This is the porous circular bottom, and the circular filter paper of the correct size, it is placed in this Bucknell funnel. And when and the filter paper has to be moist with using the water or suitable solvent. And when we have to create the suction by using vacuum pump, then the filtration has to be carried out, and at the upper part we get the residue, that is the substance which are not dissolved, and in the Bucknell flask we get the filtrate. In this way, we have studied the two types of the purification of solid techniques in filtration, that is, one is the simple filtration and another is the filtration under suction. I hope all of you understand it very well. Thank you.